Good afternoon to everybody. Today's concept is circular queues. So we are already discussed linear queues. In last class we have discussed a queue, what are the operations and everything we have discussed in last class. So now we discuss circular queues. Before going to the circular queues, first of all we go for what is linear queue, what are the problem of linear queue. In linear queues, the queue is full when rare greater than or equal to size minus 1. When rare greater than or equal to size minus 1, then the queue is full. This is called as linear. So in linear queues, all insertions will be done at rare and all deletions will be done at front. We are always insert the elements at rare and we always delete the elements at front. That is called as queue. For example, this is the one linear queue. This is a linear queue. So we are always delete the elements at front side and we always insert the elements at rear side. This is general queue. Suppose in linear queues, the queue is full when rare greater than or equal to size minus 1. For example, so if the size of the queue is 10, so when rare greater than or equal to size minus 1, so that means when rare equal to 9, then the queue is full and we cannot insert the new element. So in linear queues, the queue is full even when rare greater than or equal to size minus 1. This is called as linear queues. So this we called as linear queues. The one this is the queue. So the size of the queue is 6 elements. We are already inserted 6 elements. Then the queue is full. So suppose I want to insert one more element. No, it's not possible because rare greater than or equal to size minus 1, then the queue is full. So this problem can be avoided by using, this is the problem. In this case, suppose if I deleted 2 numbers, then the front equal to 2. If I deleted 2 numbers, so then the front equal to 2. After deletion of the queue, after the deletion of 2 elements from the queue, then the queue is 3, 4, 5, 6. Again, the queue has 3, 4, 5, 6. Suppose I want to insert one more element. So it is not possible because in linear queues, we are inserting rare greater than or equal to size minus 1. That's why the queue is full. So we have the rare. So rare greater than or equal to size minus 1, then the queue is full. This is the problem. So this is the problem. After deletion of the 2 elements, then the queue is full. Even the queue contains some empty positions because we are deleted 2 numbers. So queue has some empty positions, but it is not possible to insert the new values. This is the problem of linear queues. This problem can be avoided by using circular queues. So what is the problem of linear queues? So first of all, what is linear queue? In linear queue is a queue. All insertions will be done at rare and all deletions will be done at front. We are insert the elements at rare and we can delete the elements at front. So when rare greater than or equal to size minus 1, then the queue is full. Even the queue contains some empty positions. This is the queue, for example. So we have the suppose 6 is the size of the queue is 6. So rare greater than or equal to size minus 1, then the queue is full. Even the queue contains some empty positions. 0 and 1 are the empty positions. Even the queue contains some empty positions, we cannot insert the new value into the queue. This is the problem of linear queues. This problem can be avoided by using circular queues. One problem of linear queue is when rare greater than or equal to size minus 1, then the queue is full. Even the queue contains some empty positions. This is the problem of linear queues. This problem can be avoided by using circular queues. In circular queue, so we may when rare greater than or equal to size minus 1 and there are some empty positions, then rare is set to 0. That's we call a circular. So from 5th position to again we'll come to 0 position when there is empty positions. That's we called as linear queues, circular queues. For example, this is the circular queue. So 0th element, 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th. Again, after 4th element, again we'll come to the first 0 position. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Again, we'll come to 0. So when there are some empty positions, then we move to last position to 1st position. So that's we called as circular queues. the one solution of this problem is circular queue. In circular queue, the first index becomes to the right after the last index. So after the last index, again we will go come to the first queue. Circular queue is full. So when the queue is full, when rear equal front equal to minus one and rear equal to max minus one. So when front equal to minus one and rear equal to max minus one, then the queue is full and we cannot insert the elements. So what are the operations that are performed on circular queues? In circular queues, we are performed three operations: NQ, DQ, and display. NQ operation is used to insert an element into the circular queue. NQ operation is used to insert an element into the circular queue. DQ operation is used to delete an element from the circular. Display operation is used to print the elements of the circular. These are the three operations that are performed on circular queues. First, we'll go for NQ. How to insert an element into the circular queue? So, what is the NQ? So, when it is not possible to insert an element, when rear plus one mod size, say max means size, is equal to front, when rear plus one mod size is equal to front, then the queue is overflow, because so we are inserted up to the maximum size, up to the front. So we are inserting the elements from zero to last, again from last to again from zero to like this. So when rear plus one percentage size is equal to front, then the queue is overflow. Otherwise, the queue have some empty positions. If rear plus one percentage size equal to front, then the queue is overflow. Otherwise, if it is a first element, how we say that it is a first element? Front equal to one, rear equal to one. If it is a first element, make as front and rear equal to zero. Otherwise, if rear equal to max minus one and front not equal to zero, then set to rear equal to zero. Otherwise, rear equal to rear plus one percentage max. This is the process. We move from first to last. Then you have to insert the value at rear position. This is the algorithm. So algorithm, what is the algorithm for circular queue, NQ? So when it is not possible to insert, first this is the main condition. When it is not possible to insert the value, when it is not possible to insert a value, rear plus one percentage size is equal to front, then the queue is overflow, we cannot insert. If it is a first element, how we insert, we indicate first element, rear equal to minus one and front equal to minus one. So then we make it as front and rear equal to zero. Else, if it is we move to circular, rear equal to max minus one and front not equal to zero, then rear equal to zero. Otherwise, rear equal to rear plus one percentage size. Then you have to insert the value. So we can exit. This is the algorithm. So this is the function. If rear plus one percentage size equal to front, then print overflow. Otherwise, if front equal to minus one, rear equal to one, front equal to rear equal to zero. If rear equal to max minus one and front not equal to zero, rear equal to zero. Else rear equal to rear plus one percentage size, then you have to assign the value. This is the algorithm. So insert or NQ. So suppose this is the queue, we have the item. So when it is not possible to insert, when rear plus one percentage size or max size equal to front, queue is overflow and we cannot insert. Else, if rear equal to minus one and front equal to minus one, make it as rear and front to zero. Otherwise, if rear greater than or equal to size minus one and front not equal to zero, so then make as rear equal to zero. Otherwise, rear equal to rear plus one percentage size. Then we have to assign the value of rear equal to item. This is the algorithm to insert. Similarly, delete. So delete module is delete we called as DQ. So DQ module is used to delete an element from the queue. When it is not possible, when the queue is empty, so if front equal to minus one, if there is no value in the front queue, so if front equal to minus one, queue is underflow and we cannot delete the value. Otherwise, we can delete. then set value equal to q of rent. We can delete the value. If rare equal to front, then make it as front and rare equal to minus one. Else, if front equal to minus one, make it as a front to zero. Otherwise, front equal to front plus one. That's enough. So then this is the algorithm. So then the queue is empty. Front equal to minus one. If front equal to minus one, queue is empty. Otherwise, we can delete the element at first front position. Value equal to pure front. So then. So if front equal to rare, front equal to the rare, then so all elements are deleted. That's why then make it as front and rare to minus one. If front equal to max minus one, then make as front to zero. Otherwise, front equal to front plus one percentage size. So this is the algorithm. If front equal to minus one and rare equal to minus one, queue is underflow. We cannot insert. Otherwise, if front equal to rare, front equal to minus one, rare equal to minus one. So if front equal to max minus one, front equal to zero. So otherwise we can delete it. Front equal to front plus one percentage. So we have the display module, for example. So there is some little bit difference of the display because it is necessary to move the circular. So to move the circular, then we go for from front to rare, again rare to front. This is the one algorithm. If front less than or equal to rare, then for I equal to less, I less than or equal to rare, then we have to print the elements from front to rare. If I less than or equal to rare. Otherwise, so we have to print to max minus one, again make it as zero, again print to from position to rare. This is the algorithm to delete. So these are the algorithms of n circular queue. So what is circular queue? What are the problems? So circular queue and empty. So the one disadvantage of linear queues is when rare greater than or equal to size minus one, then the queue is full. Even the queue contains some empty positions. This is the major problem of linear queues. Suppose this is the queue. Suppose there are six. The size of the queue is six elements. We are already inserted six elements. Then the queue is full. After insertion of the six elements, then the queue is full. In this case, I deleted two numbers. After deletion of the two numbers, the queue is like this. Suppose again I want to insert one more element, it's not possible because rare greater than or equal to size minus one. When rare greater than or equal to size minus one, then the queue is full. This is the problem. This problem can be avoided by using circular queue. The one disadvantage of linear queues is when rare greater than or equal to size minus one, then the queue is full. Even the queue contains some empty positions. This is the problem. This problem can be avoided by using circular queues. In circular queues, when we reach to maximum size, again we can move to zero position. When we reach to the size minus one max size, then we can move to 0 0 1 2 3 4. Again we move to 0. If there is empty position, then we can move to last position to first position. If there is any empty position, then only. So if there is any empty position, then we can move to last position to first position. If there is no empty position, no problem. If there is some empty positions, then we can move like this. So this is the algorithm. So this is the algorithm for n queue. We can perform three operations: add queue, or we call it as n queue, d queue, and display. N queue module is used to insert an element into the queue. D queue module is used to delete an element from the queue. Display. We have the display module also. So n queue. So first we go for n queue. When it is not possible to insert an element, when it is not possible. So when rare plus one percentage size equal to front overflow, and we cannot insert. Otherwise, we can insert. If front equal to minus one, rare equal to minus one, make it as front and rare to zero. And so otherwise, if rare equal to max minus one and front not equal to zero, so rare equal to zero. Otherwise, we make it as rare equal to rare plus one. Then we can. So this is the algorithm. So this is the module. So this is the module of n queue. So insert rate plus 1% size equal to front of Q is overflow, else if front equal to minus 1 and rate equal to minus 1, make it as 0. If rate equal to max minus 1 and front not equal to 0, 0. Otherwise, we can insert. Delete Q. So delete Q means if front equal to minus 1, Q is underflow. Otherwise, we can delete the element at first position. So after that, we can delete the element at first position. And so if front equal to rare, set front to front equal to rare, then set front and rare to minus 1. If front equal to minus 1, max minus 1, front set front to 0, other front equal to front plus 1. So display is the same. Front less than or equal to rare, then we make print the elements from a front to rare. Otherwise, we can print the elements up to size minus 1, again from 0 to rare. That's one. This is the process of display. Then we will go for implementation of this circular queue. How to implement circular queues. This is the algorithm. So then we can go for implementation. How to implement circular queues by using arrays. Include IO stream dot h hash include polio dot h class circular. We have the model circular, that's why class circular. So so we make it as size constant. Int size equal to 10. Size is the q. Int q of size, comma front, comma rate. These are the variables. First we write the constructor. Void. Also constructor cannot have any return type. That's why cq circular q. This is the constructor. In circular, in constructor, I'll make it as rare equal to front equal to minus 1. I'll make rare front to minus 1. Then I write the modules. What are the operations? Void nq. Void dq. Void display. Nq add q display. These are the three modules, NQ, DQ, and display. NQ module is used to insert an element into the queue. DQ module is used to delete an element from the queue. Display module is used to print the elements of the queue. So first we go for NQ. Void CQ, circular queue. NQ. CQ, circular queue. So circular queue NQ. The circular queue is NQ is this module. So when it is not possible to insert, if. So suppose this item I want to insert int data. I'll make it as int. When it is not possible to, when, if rare plus 1. Percentage size is equal to front. If rare plus 1% size is equal to front. If so, this is the mark. If rare, actually always we are insert elements at rare. That's why rare plus 1% size is equal to front. See out Q is overflow. See out Q is overflow. See out Q is overflow. else. Otherwise, if rare equal to minus 1 and front equal to minus 1. If rare equal to minus 1 and front equal to minus 1, make it as rare and front equal to 0. Rare equal to front equal to 0. Else, otherwise. Else, if rare greater than or equal to size minus 1 and front not equal to 0. So we reach it to the last position and front is 0. No element is deleted. Not equal to 0, then make rare equal to 0. Otherwise, rare equal to rare plus 1 is enough. No need of this circular also. After that, so Q of rare equal to data. This is the value. So what is the different possibilities are there? So when the Q is full, so first of all, you have to use full condition is very important circular case. So when the Q is full, so if rare equal to rare plus 1, if rare plus 1 percentage size is equal to front, that means we are reaching to the last position and there is no empty positions. So then the Q is full. Otherwise, if it is a first element, so how we say that it is a first element, rare equal to front equal to minus 1, then make it as rare and front equal to 0. Else, so if it is not a first element, so check it is a last front equal to rare equal to size minus 1 and front not equal to 0. So then make it as a rare equal to 0. Otherwise rare equal to rare plus 1. Then you have to insert the value at rare positions Q of rare. So this is the add Q, NQ. Void CQ. Delete Q. DQ we call. DQ. So DQ module is used to delete an element from the queue. Suppose I want to delete an element from the queue, we use. So when the queue is empty, if rare equal to front equal to minus 1 and rare equal to minus 1. If front equal to minus 1 and rare equal to minus 1. If front equal to minus 1 and rare equal to minus 1, see out Q is empty. Yes. So if rare equal to minus 1 and front equal to minus 1, then the Q is empty. If so the we are always deleted element at Q of front. If rare equal to front, if rare equal to front, if rare equal to front, so when rare equal to front, then make it as rare equal to front equal to minus 1. So if rare equal to front, then I will make it as rare and front to minus 1. Because there is no elements, then make it as minus 1. Yes. Else. Else. If front greater than or equal to size minus 1. Then make to front equal to 0. Else front equal to front plus 1. So this is DQ model. So delete Q or DQ. So delete Q module is used to delete the elements from the Q. So when the Q is empty, the Q is empty when so front equal to minus 1 and rear equal to minus 1, then there is no elements. When we say that no elements, so we are always initialized with minus 1, that's why. So if front equal to minus 1, rear equal to minus 1, then the Q is empty. Suppose we have deleted the whatever the numbers we are entered, then front equal to front, then I will make it as rear and front to minus 1. If front greater than or equal to size minus 1, I will make to front equal to 0. Otherwise, front equal to front plus 1. This is the algorithm. So this is the module for DQ. Then we go for display. Void CQ. So display module is used if front equal to minus 1, cout Q is empty. Yes. If front less than or equal to rear. So if front less than or equal to rear, then I equal to 0 while I less than or equal to rear, cout Q of I plus plus post increment, I make it as post increment also. So if I less than or equal to rear, so then we print the elements from so front position to rear. That's why. So then if I equal to rear, if front less than or equal to rear, then so I'll print the elements from front position to rear. So for I equal to not 0, for I equal to front, I less than or equal to rear, I plus plus Q of I. Else means if front not less than or equal to rear. That's me, that's in this case I equal to front while I less than or equal to I less than size. See out Q of I plus plus and then one implementation is somewhat difficult. So that like this we can print the elements from front position to less than size. Then I will make it as 0, again I equal to 0 while I less than or equal rear, see out Q of I So if front equal to minus 1, then the Q is empty. If front less than rear, if front less than or equal to rear, we can print the elements from front position to rear. That's why I equal to front, I less than or equal to rear, I plus plus. Sometimes if it is go for circular, in this case we have to print the elements from front to rear. So for I equal to front, I less than or equal to size. So we print the elements, then we move to from again from zero to rear. So from zero to rear like this. So we have the increment also. Then we go for void main cq obj int ch do clr scr screen clear cout 1 nq cout 2 dq and then cout 3 display cout 4 exit cout enter your choice and then need to declare obj dot nq data obj dot display case 2 obj dot dq obj dot display break case 3 obj dot display have the programs so already told the programs in circular data structures is more than 100 lines so check it each and every program is nearly 100 lines so programs are very big you don't by heart them so there is I am always using some standard process so you have to approach that standard approach then you can get the programs very easy otherwise it's not so by hearting the program is very difficult So enter n cube, suppose 1. Enter the value to be inserted. Suppose I want to insert 10. Yes. Then the cube is 10. Again 1. Enter the value to be inserted. 20. So then the cube is 10 and 20. Suppose 1. One more. Suppose I want to insert 30. Then the cube is 10, 20, 30. Suppose 1 more. 1. Enter the value to be inserted. 40. So then the cube is 10, 20, 30, 40 like this. So always we are inserting the elements at rare. So whenever we are inserting the elements at rare, then the cube is change. Suppose I want to delete, make it as 2. So then the deleted element is 10, then the cube is 20, 30, 40. So like this. Suppose I want to delete one more element, 2. Then the cube is 20, 30, 40. Suppose I want to delete one more element. 2. I want to delete one more. 40. Then the queue is empty. Suppose I want to delete. No, queue is empty. Suppose I want to insert. Yes. Again, if I want to insert. 10. 1. 20. So this is the circular fashion. 1. 30. 1. 40. So like this we can insert. 1. 50. 160 170 180 190 100. So we have the 10 elements. So 4 6 8 10 elements. Suppose I want to insert one more. No, suppose 110. So queue overflow, we cannot insert the value because queue is overflow. Already we are, the size of the queue is 10, so the queue is overflow. In this case, suppose I want to delete one more, one element, 2. Then the queue is 10, 20, 30, 40 like this. In this case, now I want to insert, yes. So check it. Again, the last element will be come to the position. So circular order, the 20, 30, 40, 50 like this. Suppose I want to insert one more element. No, it's not possible. So we enter the value 120. No, 120, Q is overflow. So in this case, I want to delete. Delete, suppose 2. 20 is deleted. So one more. 30 is also deleted. Suppose I want to insert one more element, 120. Yes, the new element is inserted at rare. Suppose one more. 130. So like this we can insert. This is the queue. 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90 like this. So this is circular queues by using. So this is the exit. So this is about circular queues. So this is one, and the one problem of linear queues is when rare greater than or equal to size, then the queue is full. Even we are deleted some elements, that is the problem. While in the case of circular queues, so when the queue is full, so if we delete element, then we can insert the elements. That is the advantage of circular queues. The problem of linear queues is when rare greater than or equal to size minus 1, then the queue is full, even the queue contains some empty positions. That problem can be avoided by using circular queues. In circular queue, so when rare reaches to max minus 1, then we need to rare to 0. That's enough. So we can make the queue as a circular. So from last to first, that's we call a circular. So in order to make the queue as a circular, then we can use the different procedures. So add queue, n queue, d queue, and display. N queue module is used to insert an element into the queue. D queue module is used to delete an element from the queue. And the display module is used to display the values from the queue. So when the queue is full, when rare plus 1% size equal to front, rare plus 1% size equal to front, Q is overflow. Otherwise, we can insert when rare equal to minus 1 and front equal to 1, Q and rare. Otherwise, we make it as a circular. So this is the process of circular. Similarly, if rare equal to minus 1 and front equal to minus 1, Q is empty. Otherwise, we can make it as. display module is used to print the elements of the circular cube. So this is the algorithm. So this is the process. So the one when the linear is we cannot possible to, even we are deleted elements, we are not possible to insert when rare greater than or equal to size minus one. That is the major problem. That problem can be overcome by using circular queues. This is about circular queues by using arrays. Okay, bye. So tomorrow we go for circular queues by using little arrays. Ma'am, I already put a timetable on WhatsApp. No, for 1 month supply was there. Exam November lo 1 month supply got off today. 1 month supply on today. I love malla 1 2 పెడతారు మధ్యలో ఎప్పుడు వస్తాయి మీకు 1 month సప్లీలు 1 2 2 1 ఎన్ని వస్తాయి వరుసగా వస్తాయి అందుకని జాగ్రత్తగా మీరు ప్రిపేర్ అవ్వాలి సో మీ అందరికి ఆల్రెడీ వాట్సాప్ లో పెట్టాను 1 month సప్లీ వచ్చేసారు సో ఈ లోపు ఏముందంటే 2 1 1 2 పెడతారు 1 2 మిడ్ 1 2 మెయిన్ ఎన్ని పెడతారు ఈ లోపు మళ్ళా 2 1 సప్లీ 2 2 సప్లీలు పెడతారు అందుకని జాగ్రత్తగా చూసుకోండి చదువుకోండి మీరు ఎట్లా అంటే సబ్జెక్టులన్నీ మిగులుతాయి టెక్నికల్ పేపర్లు కాబట్టి అన్ని మిగులుతాయి మీరు రారు క్లాసులకి ఆ ఎన్ని ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ అయితే ఓకే బై